Suspected child sex traffickers lured two teen boys to a St. Pete trailer park with video games, online apps, and the promise of a puppy.
I-Team investigator Adam Walser uncovers new details about this case and what you need to know to protect your kids.
That's Mark, and that's Andy. They put on a good front.
Mary Homerding never suspected her neighbors were child sex traffickers.
They were always polite. They even joked around.
Because they would run by in the golf cart and wave.
Nobody in this quiet 55 and older mobile home park suspected a group of six men had been keeping two teen boys in this trailer starting in 2017.
They were really nice, you know, that's what the shocking part is.
Neighbors said they were surprised the men got away with it for so long because the boys were being held in that blue trailer just a few feet away from the neighborhood trash containers, which many of the residents of this 600-unit complex used multiple times a week.
I've never seen the kids.
Yeah, as many times I went to the garbage can because they live right across from the garbage can. I never heard anything, never seen anything out of order.
Police say the men in the trailer and another woman in North Central Florida used video games and online apps like Omegle, Roblox, and Discord to find and communicate with their victims.
The majority of people playing games are boys, and that's how our boys are lured in.
A 2016 study funded by the U.S. Department of Justice estimates 36% of child sex trafficking victims are boys. The first victim was a 16-year-old boy from Marion County.
The teenage victim in this case was lured away from his family with promises of a better life. Instead, he was moved into a filthy trailer and used as a sex slave for nearly a year.
The boy first met these two men, Mark Dennis and Andrew Clements, at their 2017 wedding. Police say he was brought to the wedding by a family friend, Eleanor McGlamory, who is charged with conspiracy in the case. Dennis and Clements immediately started texting the boy using Discord and picked him up at his home 140 miles away 3 weeks later. Police say they disabled his cell phone so he couldn't be tracked, then gave him a new name, birthday, and backstory.
And the kid was polite. He seemed happy.
Homerding says she only saw the boy once, riding a golf cart with Clements.
He introduced him as his adopted son, and the boy agreed.
Did you think it was odd that you didn't see him for months and months after that?
Well, I figured it didn't work out.
People are so busy that they go about their life and they don't always look at clues or look at signs that something could be wrong.
Police say Dennis Clements, their roommates Curtis Gruwell and Michael Schwartz, and associates Michael Blasdell and J.R. Gauthier were involved in the trafficking ring. They say four of the six men repeatedly raped the boy inside the trailer.
Yeah, I asked him if there was anything going on because it seemed like he was really depressed.
Abigail Ackerman met the victim and traffickers at a pagan festival where she says Mark Dennis offered to pay her $2,000 to make the boy a fantasy costume.
They wanted me to make him a blue and white husky suit for his birthday.
And she said the men showered the boy with other gifts.
Buying expensive things like game consoles, a full-blooded husky puppy that they bought him.
Well, that's part of the grooming process. And that's part of, even though there might not be physical chains around a victim, around a person, they have mental and emotional chains around a person.
Police say they found whips, leather mask, and bondage tools inside the trailer. According to police reports, Mark Dennis called himself Grandmaster and referred to the others as his pups, who made up what he referred to as his family circle.
We all have this deep-rooted sense that we want to have family.
But police recovered text messages showing the boy was unhappy. I'm stressed to high hell. I don't want sex all the time, the boy said nearly a year into captivity. Which is such a shame when such a tight group of people who love you have come into your life, one of his abusers replied. Then in 2018, they met a new victim online, a 17-year-old Louisiana boy they convinced to come live with them. Eleanor McGlamory and Curtis Gruwell drove about 10 hours to pick the boy up in the woods near his rural Louisiana home in the dead of night, court records show. 3 days later, Louisiana police found the boys' online messages and rescued both boys from the trailer. Now all six men are facing charges of conspiracy to commit human trafficking.
It's very, very important that we teach our children not to give out personal information.
Experts say parents should monitor their kids' online activity, especially messages with any strangers.
They have a computer in their hands that they're opened up to anything and everything in the entire world.
We posted more information on how to protect your kids on abcactionnews.com. As for the people charged with trafficking these boys, they're currently behind bars awaiting trial, and three have entered into plea deals in exchange for their testimony. I'm ITM investigator Adam Walser, taking action for you.